Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Cartwright Destiny here once again for another Cartwright Vanguard deck profiling. And today's decking question is the Pale Moon Eva Chelsea deck. Now, starting to start of the month, the starting Vanguard I choose for the deck is this card right here. Student camera. In the way I have to handle it. So my presenter is. To me, it's a very quintessential starting Vanguard for most non-Silverthorn themed decks. I know Innocent Magician's also really good, the Grade 3 Researcher, but I feel Smiling Presenter gives you much better options. Her skill is kind of last one, put her in the soul, look at the top 10 cards of your deck, or any Pale Moon card at all, put into the soul, and then you shuffle the rest back into the deck. So, she basically gives you the option to get certain cards you need into the soul when you need it. And since it's top 10 cards in your deck, that is a high amount of cards to look through and a high chance of getting getting what you need at least once. Plus a 5k body over the 4k body at least makes for a better chance of hitting certain numbers. Starting off now with the trigger lineup, I run 6 crits, 4 of Silverthorn Barking Dragon, which you can't even see, 4 of Silverthorn Barking Dragon, and 2 of Dynamite Juggler. I run 6 draw, 4 of Silverthorn Marionette Natasha, and 2 of Rainbow Magician. Rainbow Magician's skill is basically, it's kind of similar to. It's similar in a sense to Avenge Magus, Fear Magus, the Angel Feather Heal Trigger, whose name keeps slipping my mind, and Battle Riser, where when its boosted attack hits, it goes back into the deck. But what he does is, when his boosted attack hits, you get to Soul Charge 1, and then you shuffle him back into the deck. So, Recycling Draw Trigger. He's just in there as the extra draw card, which I don't ever really use for his skill. And then I run 4 Silverthorn Juggler Nadias, 4 Heal Trigger. Because I prefer Nadia over the other options. Now moving on to Grade 1s. I run two Skill Jugglers. Basically, they are your on-call Soul Charge. I run 4 Turquoise Beast Tamers because of their skill. Basically, if you have a Crimson Beast Tamer in the soul, she gains power plus 3000, making her a 9k booster. And 9k boosters are always nice. 4 Heal Triggers, 3 Hades Hypnotists, and 1 Silverthorn Hypnotist Lydia. I wanted to run 4 Lydia, but I could never get a 4th Lydia, so I bought 3 Hypnotists instead because they're cheap. And then 3 of the ever-beloved Purple Trapezes. All are the booster set version, not the promo, because I did not get that promo, which makes me really sad, because I actually like her colorations on the promo a bit more. Basically, what she does is, when she's called to Rear Guard Circle, choose Pale Moon Rear Guard, put it into the soul, and then you get to choose a Pale Moon from the soul, other than Purple Trapezes, and call it to Rear Guard Circle. So, yeah, she works in a really good combo that I'll get into a little later. Grade 2s, I run 2 Nitro Jugglers. They are basically the Grade 2 version of Skull Juggler. I run 1 Fire Breeze, Kari, or Carry. Technically, I shouldn't be running her at all, but I had no other options. 3 Dancing Princess of the Night Sky. Basically, her skill is when she's called Graveyard Circle, or Vanguard Circle. Counterblast 1. Then look at the you can search your deck for any Grade 2 or less Pale Moon and put it into the soul. She combos really, really nicely with Crimson Beast Tamer, which I run 3 of. Crimson Beast Tamer gains power plus 2000 when there's a copy of herself in the soul. So she's really good. If you're great stuff and you have another one of her in your hand, just ride her. That's all you gotta do. If you have another copy of her in hand, you're great stuff too, ride. Now you have an 11k Vanguard. And then 3 Silverthorn Marionette Lydias as my tanky attacker, because I prefer them over Barking Cerberus. Then onto my grade threes. I run four. Ramiro Kapow Eva, she's the brake ride for the clan. Her skill is when a pale moon rides over her, choose your vanguard, give the vanguard 10,000 power, and the skill of choose two of your pale moon riders and put them into the soul. When this unit attacks, you can get hooked. If you do, choose two pale moons from your soul and pull them into the rear guard circle. So basically, you brake ride herself, you brake ride her over herself. Let's say you have two Crimson Beast, Turquoise Beast Tamers on rear guard. Let's say you have two Purple Trapezes on rear guard, excuse me. You move the Purple Trapezes into the soul, then you call them back out. Then let's say you have two end unit, let's say two Lillians. You have two Lillians in front of them. You then activate each Purple Trapezes skill, put the two Lillians into the soul, and you call two Lillians in. Very powerful combo. Anyway, like I was saying, so basically, she does that, and then her other skill is she gives a soul charge 1 and give her power plus 1,000, which is a decent skill in and of itself. And then the main boss of the deck is Nightmare Bell Chelsea. Nightmare Bell Chelsea basically lets you, when her after the turn she attacked the Vanguard, Cataclysm 2, Persona Blast, basically you take Chelsea from your hand, put it into the drop zone, and you get to take two pale moons from your soul, and you call them the rear guard. I'm very sorry if you have not seen this card at all. So basically, another combo. When you break ride that turn, let's say your field was set up like this. You had two of these on the field. You had all three of your Crimson Beast Hammers in the soul. And you had two Turquoise Beast Hammers on the rear guard. So you break ride that turn over Miracle Pop Eva. Eva's skill. You take your two Turquoise Beast Hammers, put them into the soul, pull them back out on rear guard circle. So you had your rear guard attack first. Then, after you attack with Chelsea, you activate her Persona Blast, drop a copy of her from your hand, retire the two Lillians you had on rear guard circle, then you pull out two Crimson Beast Hammers from the soul. You still have the third one in the soul. And now Crimson Beast Tamer and Turquoise Beast Tamer are on the field together for a nice, powerful 20k hit. Even more so if you twin drove any triggers and you gave the power of the triggers to beat to a Turquoise. The other nice thing with them is, to those who are in the loop of the current formats, these are full art images. These two go together hand in hand, make the 20k column, early Legion pretty much. Now we all know the first. Technically, the first Legion in the entire game was King and Queen, King of Knights and Queen of Swords. I mean, a King of Swords and Queen of Spades, I think it was, I don't remember. But basically, King and Queen, the 10k attacker, and the and his booster from Nova Grappler. But it's still nice to see these things. But yeah, that's pretty much this deck in a nutshell, and that's the combo of this deck. It's basically all about getting multiple hits late game and building your soul up to be able to be able to do those things. Now, the only flaw with this deck is the fact that the main Vanguard of the deck is unfortunately a 10k power, which is extremely useful. Oh, and I forgot her other effect is when she's boosted by a Pamela and she becomes 13k for that turn, for that attack. But the only drawback to her is she's 10k. And as we all know, in this current format, 10k units are extraordinarily abusable. And why is my auto focus on? My auto focus actually shouldn't be on. Why is my focus all on? There we go. Sorry about that. But that's the main flow with her. And that's why, technically speaking, you use her only the very end, and you just keep brake riding into Eva every turn just to really mess with the opponent. Eva is the main unit of the deck, in my opinion, because she's the one that gives all the power and skill. So you constantly brake ride into her every turn you can, before punishing the opponent in the very end by brake riding into Chelsea. And if you can pull that off, you really wreck your opponent. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. This is my my deck profiling on my Eva Chelsea deck. If you like what you saw, leave a comment down below, give this video a thumbs up, and stay tuned for more. I have more videos on the way, hopefully something maybe not Vanguard related next time around, even though I really shouldn't be saying hopefully, because Vanguard is my thing. That's about it, and I'll see you all later, people. Peace.